Well, playing football, I love the sport in general, and it keeps me fit first of all, and travelling the world with the Scotland squad has been fantastic. We've progressed over the years and I think that's only made me a better person and a better player. People don't realise how tough it is. Like, I speak to my friends and family who only think it's a disability squad, but when they come up and see the standard of the players and the fitness, it was very, very difficult. And if we don't maintain that away from here, then it shows when we come to the training, because like, you obviously know when people have been not doing their programmes because they work very, very hard. The main thing with the squad is it's very, very difficult to find players. I think if we need to kick on, we need to get more players in and obviously better players in. We've really, really had a close-knit group and I've met a few friends, and like one of my friends got married in the squad a few months ago and the whole team went, and I think we've got off-the-field attributes as well, and that kind of brings us on together. So I think that's been really, really good for me as well. Scottish Disability Sport has been a great framework for everybody in the squad. I think they've really helped me out a lot over the years. If I need any like funding or if I need any like time off my work, they contact my work. They've really been a great support network, not just for me but for anybody involved, and they also get people into work as well. So Scottish Disability Sport have been fantastic for me, and I'm sure that'll continue over the years to come. Anybody who has cerebral palsy or acquired brain injury should get in touch, because the standard is fantastic and I think you only progress as a player. You never know, you could be representing your country just by one phone call.